Please take a look at these videos. These videos all share a unified pattern. They feature a fashionable beauty together with landmark buildings from all over the world. The purpose of constructing such videos is mainly to allow everyone to experience the realism of the video. However, the realism of the video does not originate from the video itself, but from the images used to generate this video. To generate this image, we utilized a model. This model is called Rebalance. This model is a fine-tuned version of Qwen Image. The author fine-tuned this model for mainly two objectives. The first objective is to facilitate the generation of certain cosplay images. The second objective is to generate high-quality images that possess realism. In this file list, we can see that what is currently provided includes both the full model and Laura. Furthermore, Laura is available in different rank types and, naturally, different sizes. We still advise everyone to download the main model. Its size is 20 gigabytes, which is basically equivalent to our Qwen image model. In addition, it also provides a ComfyUI workflow. This workflow does not require installing any additional extensions. You can use it just by dragging it directly into your ComfyUI. I have also built the workflow onto Running Hub. You can access this platform through Running Hub in the ComfyUI field. Running Hub is a fantastic online working platform because as soon as new models and new extensions appear, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link provided in my video description. This allows you to receive 1,000 free points. Furthermore, logging into Running Hub daily will also give you 100 bonus points. This means you can try out your own workflows for free. Next, let's take a look at what this provided workflow looks like. This workflow can be divided into two sections. The upper section is essentially a Qwen image workflow. The lower section has many different nodes, which might look quite messy to us. So why are these nodes present? Let's return to the model description. Please note, in the introduction to this model, we will find that when it generates high-quality photorealistic images, it utilizes a JSON prompt. This JSON prompt consists of 9 different sections to describe the image in detail. These 9 sections include our subject, foreground, middle ground, background composition, visual guidance, color tone, the design of lighting and shadows, and our overall prompt. You will see that it covers all facets of image generation. Returning now, this section of the workflow is actually intended to generate this JSON format prompt. Let's run it now and observe the result. There's a point here that is somewhat unconventional because this model has already been uploaded to Running Hub. When I attempted to upload it again, it prompted that it already existed. However, I discovered that the model was not in the diffusion models directory. It was uploaded to Checkpoint instead, leading to this issue. I currently have no way to upload a new one. Therefore, I am forced to use the load checkpoint node to load this model. Logically, you should be using load diffusion model to load this model. So, if you plan to use this workflow of mine, please remember to replace this specific node, alright? Now this has finished running, we are able to get an image like this. Everyone can see that the overall sense of realism is very strong, including the background design and the character's posture, because it utilizes complex composition methods, such as foreground, middle ground, and background. The entire picture features many elements. Next, let's take a look at the prompt. Everyone, look, this is the final effect. Of course, you can also choose not to use the JSON format prompt. Using a traditional prompt is also feasible. However, the quality of the final generated image might not be as high. If we had to use that method to generate the prompt, it would be too troublesome. Therefore, I restructured it. Take a look, my workflow is now extremely simple. Here, we primarily use our Qwen 3VL to replace the long series of nodes from before. Because the Qwen 3VL model actually possesses very strong capabilities in image recognition, image understanding, and text understanding. Therefore, we will make full use of its abilities to have it generate the corresponding prompt for us. Alright, next let's briefly summarize this workflow. First, we have the loading of the main model similarly as I just explained. If you use this yourself, you should be using load diffusion model and not load checkpoint. Next are our encoder and our VAE. Here, we recommend generating vertical images. This is because horizontal images inherently have a less realistic or slice of life feel. This is why people shooting vlogs usually shoot vertically, whereas we shoot tutorials horizontally. My current resolution setting is 896 by 1536. We will detail the prompt engineering for Qwen image later. After that, we load an acceleration model. This covers our positive prompt and our negative prompt. The sampler settings are quite conventional. Please pay attention. The sampling algorithm is Euler, but our scheduler uses beta instead of the traditional symbol. After decoding, we will obtain the corresponding image. Now, let's look at how the prompt should be written. You need to pay attention. The prompt engineering here is divided into two sections. One is called the system prompt or system instruct, which is essentially the system instruction. Below that is our user prompt. In the user prompt, you only need to clearly state what you want to generate. There is no need to write it in excessive detail, because the large language model LM will help you construct the remaining parts. Of course, this version I showed is in Chinese. I have also provided everyone with an English version of the prompt engineering. All right, next, let's first look at how this prompt engineering is written. The prompt engineering is actually very straightforward. The beginning is a definition of the role. We position the LOM's role as a professional AI image prompt engineer. Its core job is to expand upon a topic that I provide and then generate a structured prompt. Furthermore, it must be written in JSON format. This JSON needs to be composed of 9 key components. We have already discussed these 9 parts, and for each part, I have included a very explicit description. Next, we have the generation steps, which the model needs to follow step by step. The only part I want to emphasize to everyone is the 4th step. Step 4 mandates that it needs to verify whether the entire prompt is logically consistent. For example, if we specify a very close-up viewpoint for the composition, the prompt should not include elements like feet. This is because, since it is a close-up shot, it usually focuses on the upper body. Therefore, to avoid such unnecessary confusion, we emphasized here that it needs to verify the logical consistency of the overall composition. Everyone should pay attention to this point when writing prompt engineering. Alright, next we paste the prompt into this location. We try to write these 2 parts in this manner because currently, unlike using an LOM for conversation, it doesn't function like a chat with painting capabilities. Therefore, we must inform it that the preceding text is our system prompt, and the following text is the user input. The theme we set for generation is a beautiful woman in front of the Taj Mahal. Now, let's generate it and observe the result. Everyone, look at the generation result. It is excellent. This includes the overall presentation of the figure, the depiction of the clothing, and the rendering of the entire Taj Mahal in the background. I believe it is all fantastic. Here, we need to emphasize that the training data for this model was likely trained using a large amount of photorealistic images of East Asian subjects. Therefore, its ability to depict East Asian figures is slightly stronger. Its depiction of Western figures will be slightly weaker. So please keep this in mind when you use it. Also, as we stressed, it is best to use a vertical aspect ratio. It is not impossible to use a horizontal format, but the sense of realism may not be as good. Using this concept, you can generate images of a beauty taking photos with global landmarks and subsequently transform them into videos. This is the result we observed at the very beginning. However, beyond this, the model can actually display many other scenarios very effectively. Look at these examples. The realism is also very strong. Therefore, the entire core principle lies in your ability to write relatively good prompt engineering. If you currently do not possess this ability, you can first use the prompt engineering that I have provided to achieve the goal of generating images with a stronger sense of realism. Well, what are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me and become someone who understands AI.